A question about the evolution of the UiPath community. Thank you for that. Brings a bit of nostalgia. So how has community initiatives evolved at UiPath before versus after you joined? As a community builder, what is that one thing or top three things that is indispensable to you? Thank you for this one. So I started at UiPath more than 4 years ago. And back then, what we had an active forum, which was the heart of the community, a resourceful academy, a free accessible academy for everyone to learn automation, to learn RPA with UiPath, and a community edition version of our product, which was open, and it helped the community grow together with the product and the product together with the community based on the feedback that we were collecting. So that was there. And there was also a lot of enthusiasm from the company, a lot of support for the community to grow. Community was recognized as one strategic advantage, which we just needed it to continue to grow. Once I joined, I started to put together a strategy for things to develop programs, to know how to engage our users, how to engage our community members, develop the first advocacy programs, so giving the first recognition to our community, starting our first hackathons. When I started, it was just in the planning phase. Like we were planning a hackathon, and so the entire execution happened. Many new things, many new developments and layers of community. I got the chance to develop together with a new developed team, global team. So that was also an important aspect of growing the community strategy and vision. I had a good start, given that there was a healthy community, an engaged community when I started. So my responsibility was even bigger. And also the people with whom to grow, they were there. So that was really, really nice. Now, regarding things that are indispensable to me, I think these are more like concepts, things that I get and I cannot touch. So the first thing that is indispensable, I think that really getting this sense that the community is a sounding board. So creating that space that for people to trust us and to be as authentic as possible. So through community, you get to hear that feedback that is valuable, and you need to let it come to you as it is. So this is one aspect, the distrust, the sounding board from the community space. The second aspect is the relationship. So making sure that there is a relationship with the other, a relationship from us to them, but also in between them. So building relationships is something that it's quite important. Otherwise, you just have an audience, you don't have a community. And the third aspect, again, like it's abstract, I cannot put it in a different way. It's making sure that there is a bigger purpose. Like everything that you generate gets aligned to something. People do contribute in the community because there is a value that we agreed, we articulate, and it makes sense. Like we are not pushing them into any direction. We are not there just to please someone for the sake of pleasing. So a bigger purpose helps a lot. So sounding board, relationship, and bigger purpose are quite abstract, but they are indispensable, and I think anyone can nurture them.